I'm driving 10 gears on this side, 25 gears on this side. So I'll cross over here off of this half of the drivetrain, come over on the back side.
When possible, I'm trying to use existing arbor or axle points from the front side. I was able to do that for these three gears. And there's a gear under here which turns independent of the Geneva mechanism. This gear train will be driven from the other side. This one, I believe, will be turning about this fast. This is about a 9-to-1 reduction. It cycles the Geneva mechanism one position and advances the ratchet one click. This is a Dayton spring motor. It's out of a wind-up record player, and generally these are over 100 years old. The springs were originally lubricated with a mixture of graphite and Vaseline, and the accumulation of oil and grease on this. You can see from the original photographs, this was pretty dirty when I got it. Getting the springs out of here is one thing. Lubricating both sides of the spring and shoving it back in this can, maintaining control of it, and this time I used white lithium grease. This is wanting to jump out of there and slap you about the head and shoulders until you get that last little bit to snap in there. After you get those two springs stuffed back in there, it's time for a beer. It's always a good feeling when you put it together and it runs straight away. And very quiet. This is my highly calibrated matchstick. These spring motors are kind of interesting. Usually you will see a worm driving a wheel, but in this case you have a wheel driving a worm, and in some of these motors they do it twice. Very well made ratchet mechanism on this winding shaft. You got that pin works on that cam. And ordinarily this would be facing down, but in any position, when you wind this, actuating lever is spring loaded and it comes back, and that pawl will engage with the ratchet. Pretty good little safety feature. There are quite a few variations of these spring motors. This is a two-spring motor. This is a winding shaft. You turn the winding shaft two times to turn this once. This shaft is attached to the small end of the spring on this side of the drum. The two drums are tied together. Winding this spring also winds this one. And then the small end of the spring on this drum is attached to the large gear. So you wind the motor with this shaft, and then this gear runs the motor. The drive shaft or spindle shaft was tapered in this area, and the turntable for the record player sat on that taper. I've machined that to a 5/16 diameter, and the drive gear for the gear head will attach to that. When the motor is mounted in the phonograph, the turntable sits on the spindle. The weight of the turntable is transferred directly to the end of the shaft, which is cupped out and rides on a single steel ball. There's a hole drilled in this casting, and that shaft passing through there, it's really more for stability, not so much a bearing, even though it did have a felt around here to keep it oiled. When I run this in a horizontal position, I didn't really think that that was a good support for that shaft. I installed a 5/16 oil light bushing for the shaft to run in on this side of the head, and I intend to have the same thing on the other side as well. I have this slowed to a speed where it will run on 35 turns for about 11 minutes. At this speed, it'll run for about 6 minutes. In the course of making this, I've had front side gears working and back side gears working. But generally, I've not had front and back working at the same time. Some of these share arbors with the front side gears. I just need to adjust the lengths so that they're adequate for the keepers that we'll push on here to hold the gears in place. A number of these positions need new arbors made for the gear sets that do not share an arbor with the front side.